Coach Crawford here for some post-Murph recovery. I'm sure some of you are probably feeling a little sore today after your mile run, 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, 300 air squats, and another mile run. And some of you crazies doing it in a weight vest. So a few tips are stretches, recovery items that I have for you to do today as a way to kind of help get that soreness, work it through the body, so that we can get back in and get after it today, tomorrow, and the rest of the week. So we'll start first by thinking about pull-ups, feeling pretty sore from that. So what we can do is we can grab our foam roller here. We'll take this foam roller. What you want to do is kind of use it as a way to assist to get into a child's position. So getting your palms flat here and rolling forward, letting your chest and head dive through, holding that for about 5 to 8 seconds, then coming up and repeating that about 20 to 30 times just to help open up our lats. Once you've done that, then you can actually work on rolling the lat itself. So you want to get on the side here, extend your arm, roll that meaty part right beneath your armpit. You want to roll up and down. You can raise your hips up to spice this up a little bit. Turn your hand, palm back, turn your palm forward, arm pulled back. Just find those little hot spots. If you find that sticky spot, just hang out there. Small little rolls back and forward. You want to go about a minute to 2 minutes on each lat just to help get through that soreness from those pull-ups. Next, what we're going to look at is thinking about all the push-ups, the worst part about Murph. Now, some of you may have broken this up Cindy style on 5, 10, 15 to get through your pull-ups, push-ups, and squats, and some of you may have gone straight through. So your degree of soreness may vary, meaning how you handle some of this. Your pain faces might be a little bit more intense than others, depending on what you did. So thinking about push-ups, we probably have a lot of soreness in our biceps with the push-ups as well as the pull-ups, and then some soreness right here in between our pec and our shoulder. So one great way to help attack that, both those parts of our body, is using the barbell here. Now, some of you I know are gonna be cringing watching me do this, but trust me, this is gonna be a huge help in helping reduce that soreness and getting you recovered and back at it. So, just kind of lay down. What we want to do is take this barbell, and you want to place that right in between your pec and shoulder. I like to extend my arm, and then I'll roll small rolls back and forward. Now, if you want to add a little bit of spice to this, you can take your foot, press down on that barbell as you are rolling it. You can also get a friend. Ask a friend to step on that barbell. They won't mind. Working that small little area between the shoulder and pec, then roll over that shoulder. Be careful, take the pressure off a little bit. It can be a little funky. Then you want to get on your bicep. You'll be rolling up and down that bicep, turning your palm toward the floor, turn your palm up to the sky. You can raise your arm up a little bit and go all up and down that bicep. It is going to be spicy, okay? But again, we want to make sure that we help ourselves recover, really work through it with this. So go ahead, spend again a minute to 2 minutes each side getting after your area between your pec and your shoulder as well as your bicep, helping with those pull-ups and push-ups there. Lastly, we have all those air squats. So I know quads are going to be blown up from this. So we can get at this one of two ways. My personal favorite would be to take the barbell and do a barbell snatch. So you take the barbell right here, just placing that right on your quad. You're just going to roll that up and down, treating your quad like a nice little roll of dough, rolling it out with the rolling pin. So go in there and you can rotate your foot side to side, getting the inner part of your quad, top part of it, and then the side a little bit. Again, we want to go a minute to 2 minutes each leg, working that out. And again, you can always get someone to step on this barbell and really help you out. If you find those hot, sticky spots, always spend an extra little time there, small little rolls back and forward on those. If this is too much for you, what you can do is you can grab the foam roller. So if we grab the foam roller right here, what I'm going to do, place it like so. I can get both of my quads on this, right, starting right at the top of the knee, just rolling back and forward here. You want to give yourself a good minute, minute and a half, rolling back and forward. Now, if you want to attack different angles of your quads, what you can do is put one quad on at a time. So what I like to do, put that to the side a little bit. I'll get my left quad. I'm going to place that in here. I get my other leg out, our knee out. It's kind of like a kickstand. And then I roll back and forward here. Okay? And I can also bring my knee up and get the inner part of my thigh as I roll up and down into that quad. Get into your hips a little bit because the hips will be sore from all those squats. Again, a minute to 2 minutes each leg should help with that soreness a little bit. Now, if you really want to target areas more, you can always grab the lacrosse ball. So you can take this lacrosse ball. We can work on the parts of our shoulder that we're working during the pull-ups. Take this lacrosse ball, lay on it right on your scap, and you're just going to go up and down with your hand, rolling that around, again, finding those sticky spots. Another minute to 2 minutes here. And if that barbell is a little too much or not enough for you in some cases, what you can do is you can take the lacrosse ball, place it right between the shoulder and the pec, and lay down on that and just roll side to side, bury yourself in here. You can hang out, fall asleep, take a nap for 3 minutes each side. That should really help open up after all of those push-ups. So, that's what we got for Murph Recovery. Hopefully some of these tools will be helpful. If you are unsure how to do any of this, you can find me or any of the other coaches, and we'll be more than happy to help instruct you. Happy recovery. This is Top of Tuesday. Thanks for everybody who came out and did Murph yesterday. It was a great time, and looking forward to the burpees on June 8th. See you.